Let's go ahead and add some sound now. Now, in Theasys, there are two different ways that you can add sound. One of them is to the entire tour, for example, sort of background music, or you can add sounds to each individual panorama. I'm going to show you both, but let's start with the panorama sound first, as it's the easier of the two. So you have the picture here that you want to add the sound to. What you do then is you go ahead and go into the panorama properties. From there, you can see all the different menus. Open up panorama background sound. Now you have a choice of audio file types. Pay attention to them. MP3s are smaller and generally better. Wave is an older format and the file sizes are a little bit larger. So once you know, I'm going to go ahead. I have waves today and we're going to pick that one. Okay. Now, obviously, you're going to want to make sure that your audio files are copyright free or you're not using somebody else's work. So once your file is uploaded, let's go ahead and give it a preview. You can set this to autoplay. That means that as soon as the user clicks on that, it will begin to play. And there's your sound there. You also can make it play forever. It can loop. You can't loop it a certain number of times. This will just keep on playing as long as the user is actually looking at the panorama. Here you have a delay. Once the sound effect has stopped playing on a loop, you can add a pause in here. Now, this is especially good for text. If you are doing maybe narration and you have somebody talking, well, then you might want to give the listener a pause before the entire thing starts again. All right, so that's done in seconds. But we have an audio clip of music, so we're not going to be using any of that. I'm just going to keep the loop on. All right, so there is how you'll add it for one picture only. If you want to add it to the entire tour, I'm going to delete this and show you how to do that. So let's go back into the Project Properties pane, and here you have a special one. It's called Tour Background Sound. It has the same setup, and we're going to add maybe the same wave to it. So we're going to add that sound to it. Now this will play over the entire tour. That means when they click from picture to picture, then that sound effect will remain. However, things like loop, delay, and other tour background sound options, you have to set them somewhere else. This is where it becomes a little complicated. So let me show you that. Click on Customize and Preview. And it's going to click you out here. Now remember, when we opened our tour, we added all of this information. That's fine. But after that, you're going to need to click on Customize. That's going to bring up another menu with lots and lots of different choices. So let's go ahead and scroll right down here to Background Sound. Open that one. There is where the menu for this will appear. I suspect Theasys will probably change this later, but for now, this is where it is. So we're going to force this for all panoramas. There you go. We're going to make it autoplay. And we're going to loop it. Okay, so we're going to add that. Now, that's going to trigger this to enable audio, to allow the user to decide if they want to do it or not. So we can go ahead and test it ourselves and click that. And there you go. Okay. Let's see if it'll work in other places there. So that way, wherever they go, they're going to be hearing the same sound. Now, this last one here, it says show option in menu. Let me explain that one to you really quickly. This is the menu. So you can see there are different things here. The user can use that. If you don't want the sounds to appear in the menu, just turn it off. Okay. And there, it will disappear from that. All right, but I think it's a good idea to keep this in, so you'll probably want to leave that on.